is Alex Shapiro. I'm with Sony Electronics, and you're watching Actors Reporter with Kirk Kelly.
Kirk Kelly for Actors Reporter Live Video Inc. from the AFI special Sony party with Alex Shapiro, who's the president of Sony's Integrated Solutions.
Actually, Professional Solutions. It's the non-consumer side of the Sony business.
And what are you debuting here at AFI tonight?
Well, what we're announcing is a program with the AFI where we're going to be using AFI alumni directors to shoot short films in 4K using our cameras. We have several 4K cameras, the F65, F55, and F700. And it's part of our overall lens to living room strategy, creating content for new 4K TVs being introduced in the market.
Right. Now, will you be able to shoot 3D 4K, or is that something that's still down the road?
Well, you can.
Okay.
You can take a 4K camera and set it up and shoot the same style as you do with 2K. It looks really dynamite. But it's really 4K gives you four times the resolution of 2K, and frankly, with 3D, I'm not sure you need 3D. I mean, the depth of field is so great with 4K that it looks really well without the 3D effect.
So this will be bumpable virtually to any format?
Yes. In fact, a lot of TV series are currently being shot with our cameras. They're being aired on primetime, like Blacklist, Michael J. Fox show. But obviously they're being distributed in 2K, but they're being archived in 4K for syndication future use.
Would I be able to take this and also shoot something and then put it on IMAX with 4K?
Well, sure. You could shoot with an F65 in particular for IMAX.
Okay.
That would work fine.
So where do you see the future of this all going as we're moving at a fast pace with today's technology?
Well, I think as the screen sizes at home get larger and larger, that's what really drives the demand for higher resolution. And we've always been seeking the equivalent or better of 35mm film.
Have you found it with 4K?
And so I think we found it with 4K, yes.
Okay. So what is the actual resolution of 4K for those who aren't familiar with
it? It's 4096 by 2040.
Amazing.
So it's versus 1920 by 1080.
Now, will there be extra audio tracks on this also, or that really doesn't matter?
No, it doesn't matter. You can if you like.
Okay.
Yeah.
And will there be any other special requirements for using this type of gear, or is it pretty user-friendly?
It's pretty user-friendly. The workflow that goes with the production process is similar to that of 2K.
Okay.
And in terms of television and sports, it's actually a lot easier than 3D because you can actually shoot in 4K, and then you can derive 2K out of it, whereas in 3D, you really need different camera positions.
Now, this is obviously new to North America. Will this be deployed worldwide to PAL and other formats?
Yeah, it's really not that new.
Okay. Educate me.
Yeah, so we started 4K about 7-8 years ago, and over the last 5 years, we put 4K projectors into about 11,000 movie theaters in the United States.
Mm-hmm.
So 4K as a display technology in motion picture theaters has existed for some time. It's only in the last 2 or 3 years that we put together the production technology to support it.
Right.
And now we're taking the next step in bringing it, bringing the 4K experience to the home.
I see. So there will be actual televisions that can adapt this technology and see it in the full quality.
You need a new television.
Ah.
Yes.
That Sony will be offering soon, I'm hoping.
It offers it now. We have 84, 65, and 55. In screen sizes.
Really?
Yes.
How long have these been on the market?
We introduced the 84 inch about a year ago. It was very expensive.
Yes.
That was $25K.
$25,000 for
Yes.
Nice.
But
not
for
your
you,
average
but
home
for
year.
You.
Yes.
No, but we just recently introduced 55 and 65. Currently in the stores for $4,000 and $6,000 respectively.
Much more affordable.
Yeah. And by the way, they are also the best 3D TVs that you'll ever see. They use passive glasses, and the picture quality is phenomenal. The TVs actually up-res 2K to 4K. So the picture quality is really superb.
So when you say they use passive glasses, they're not the typical real thick 3D glasses that someone
might
use.
They're the ones that, the throwaway glasses that you get at a movie theater.
Really easy to use.
Easy to use, inexpensive. You can buy them for your family and friends.
You're always on the cutting edge with technology. Are there some new things on the horizon coming soon we should be watching for?
Well, we actually have now even a 4K consumer camcorder.
Really?
So you can even shoot your kid's soccer game in 4K.
Are you serious?
Which I think every pet parent will want that.
Absolutely. Yes. Of course, dad's your 80-inch screen TV that's 4K.
There you go.
What is the price of these going to be starting at?
Oh, very inexpensive. About $5,000-$6,000.
Oh, very affordable.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And probably, from my perspective on the pro side, too good.
Oh, really?
They're going to be very good.
What is the price of the 4K cameras, the newer ones, out on the market?
The ones that we sell, the highest end now is, we actually have one that's about $85,000, but the one being used more often is about $35,000.
And how easy are the lenses to change out, or are they stock lenses that?
Lenses are very easy to change out. They'll work with traditional PL mount, 35 millimeter film style lenses.
So you can adjust to whatever it is you're trying to create as an effect.
Yeah.
Truly impressive technology.
Thank you very much.
I look forward to hearing more about it.
I appreciate
you for joining us tonight. I'll be back with more in a moment from AFI.